Hi guys! By the end of this video, you will be able to start growing your email list by sending out beautiful lead magnets such as ebooks, recipe cards, calendars, diary inserts, and so on to your new subscribers. Last week, I showed you how to create your Mailchimp sign-up form and share the link on social media. This week, I'm going to walk you through the rest of the sign-up process. And I'll finish off by showing you exactly how to attach your lead magnet in PDF format to your final welcome email. If you're new to my channel, I'm really happy to see you. I'm Nicky Pasquier, I'm a Canva certified creative and a HubSpot email marketer. It's my absolute passion to share with small business owners like you the best digital marketing tips, tricks and tools to help you succeed online. So be sure to subscribe to my channel and turn that little bell notification on so that you're the first to know when I publish a new video. So if you're ready, let's hop over to my Mailchimp account. If you watched last week's tutorial, you'll already know how to find your sign-up form builder. I'll leave the link in the description box below so you can watch it later if you missed out. Starting on your form builder, I'm going to click on this drop-down menu. And you can see that after prospects have clicked on the subscribe button on the sign-up form, there's a sequence of six possible messages that they will receive afterwards. These little messages are really quick and are automated, so you don't need to action anything. I ran through my own sign-up sequence and this is what it looks like. It took less than a minute from hitting the subscribe button to receiving the final welcome email. So I'm going to explain the sequence of messages to you, starting with the sign-up form with alerts. I'm just going to click on it. Scrolling down, this will appear if your subscribers have missed some key information while subscribing to your list. So perhaps they've missed out their email address, their first name, or maybe they've missed out on the GDPR marketing permissions. So these little messages here will just prompt them to leave the requested information. Scrolling back up to the top, the next message they will receive is the sign-up form thank you page. You can customize these messages by hovering your mouse over the text boxes in the top right-hand corner and clicking on the little edit button. This little text box will appear just as it did in your sign-up form, where you can add text, edit it with these tools at the top, and even include an image. At the moment, these messages are very general and a little bit robotic, so you can make them sound a little bit more personal by including your subscriber's first name. If you make any changes, be sure to click on Save and Close so that you save your changes. If you're a sole trader, you might want to change the we to I in this message. The next message in the sequence is the opt-in confirmation email. This is the message your subscribers will receive if you set up a double opt-in. Again, you can customize each of these text boxes by hovering your mouse over the right-hand corner and clicking on Edit. The next message in the sequence is a recapture confirmation, and this is pretty straightforward, but if you want to have a little bit of fun, you could always add an emoji or even a GIF file. Once again, if you've made any changes, don't forget to save the changes and close this text box down. The next message is the confirmation thank you page. This is slightly different. So that subscribers don't think this is the final welcome email and you've forgotten to attach whatever it is they've signed up to receive, let them now know to look out for a further email from you very shortly. You could even let them know what the title of your next email will say. Now we come to the final welcome email, and this next step is incredibly important. If you want to send the final welcome email from this series, you must remember to put a tick in this box here. Otherwise, your welcome email will not be sent. Scrolling down, I'm going to change the subject line of my email, since I asked my subscribers to look out for an email in their inbox entitled, "Your goodies have arrived." So I need to change this subject line to "Your goodies have arrived." Right, so scrolling down to the message itself, here is where you're going to include your welcome message. So I'm going to hover my mouse over the top right hand corner and click on the edit button. The first thing I'm going to do is to change this first sentence just to make it a little bit more personal and a little less boring. Next, you can write whatever you want, but if you're going to be really professional, which I know you are, you might want to bear in mind a couple of best practices. Number one, expectations. At this point, be clear about what subscribers can expect to receive from you and how frequently. So you might let them know that you're sending out a newsletter every fortnight. Number two, always let subscribers know how to unsubscribe from your emails. It's the law. And finally, we've come to the fun part where we're going to deliver that PDF file you've promised your subscribers. Firstly, you want to add a little bit of text and add a hyperlink to the file you want to attach. So I'm going to select the text, head up to the toolbar and click on the link icon. Next, I'm going to click on this drop-down menu to link to a file. Mailchimp will now take me over to my content studio where I can either click to upload my file from my laptop, for instance, or I can select it from my content studio. All I need to do now is click on insert. And here is the file link. Click on insert again. And there is your hyperlinked text that links out to your file. You might want to make your email a little bit more interesting by including an image of your file. I'm going to decrease the size slightly because this is enormous. Don't forget, when adding images to emails, you must remember to add an alt text because not all email clients display images by default. Now click on Save and Insert Image. Including an image also helps subscribers know exactly what they're going to get. And you might be thinking, well, it's obvious, isn't it? Because they've signed up to receive something. But remember, new subscribers may not know you too well at the moment, so you have to win their trust by being totally transparent. Next, include your sign off and save and close your message. And here is your final welcome email. If you want to test out that whole sequence yourself, like I did, go back to your sign-up form, copy and paste the sign-up form URL, send it to yourself by email, and subscribe to your own list or ask somebody else to do it for you. Congratulations, that is it, and you're all done now. I think you deserve a massive pat on the back because now you can not only set up a Mailchimp sign-up form, you can also add GDPR marketing permissions to it, share the link on social media, and you can also deliver a free piece of content to your new subscribers in a final welcome email. So I think you should be very proud of yourselves. If you feel that these tutorials are really helping you to understand email marketing and to take away a bit of that confusion, let me know in the comments box because I'd be really interested to find out. If you missed out on last week's tutorial, make sure you do watch it. I'll leave the link in the end screen, which is coming up in just a few minutes. If you enjoyed my tutorial, please do give it a like because it helps me to grow my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching and I will see you again next time.